Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at how do you get data in Power BI, because there's different ways to do it, from importing to direct query to live connections and more. What's it all mean? Let's find out. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. Getting data inside of Power BI, like I said, it can be a little confusing with all the different terms that are going around, but we're gonna break that down. Let's start off with import. When we say we're importing data, this is also referred to as cache data. What it means is that we're actually pulling data from your data source, bringing it into Power BI as a copy of that data, and then it sits inside of your Power BI desktop file. If you then publish that to the service, that data set where the data is resides inside of Power BI. And when we query items from a visual perspective, it's hitting that cache data. One of the biggest benefits to this is that it's super fast and there's data compression involved. So you can get a lot of data in a tiny little bit of space. Another benefit that we have here is when we go to get data and we look at all of the data sources that are part of Power BI, you'll see that there's a lot of data sources here. All of these are available from an import perspective. So there's no restrictions on that. Even if you're doing ODBC or anything, connecting to any data and bringing it in, you have full capabilities of Power BI, including all of the DAX functions, all the relationship types, all of the stuff you can do in Power Query. Everything is available for you 100% in import mode. This is the default option, and usually it's the option that I recommend to folks. And you may be thinking, or you may have heard like, well, yeah, I can only do a million rows. That's all I can do. No, you can do a lot in import. I'm working with one customer where they've got inside of Power BI 1.5 billion rows imported. They're actually trying to push it even bigger. So you can go a long way. Let's take a look at an actual data source here. So if I go to get data, we're just going to go to SQL Server. And when we put in our server and database information, you'll have another option here for data connectivity mode. So you've got an option of import or direct query. Import's the default option, and that's going to bring in that cached version of the data. Direct query is also an option. We'll talk about that in a second. So import is available for everything, like I mentioned. If you are not using premium capacity, your data set size, so this is the on disk size of the Power BI desktop file, can only go up to 1 gig in size when you go to publish that to the service. So that's going to be one restriction from an import perspective and something you need to be mindful of. If you are using premium, you can go up to 10 gigs, which is the default. You can even go beyond 10 gigs with large model support up to what your premium capacity can actually manage. One pro tip I'm just going to throw out there from a modeling perspective when you're doing import of the data is keep it simple, keep it clean. I've got a link in the description below to a document in the guidance section of the Power BI docs for star schemas. Read up on this, make sure you're familiar with what this is, fact tables, dimension tables, how to relate those things together. It is very important for the best performance. Don't just do one giant single table, please, I beg. All right, let's look at direct queries. In import, I mentioned that we copy the data into Power BI. With direct query, it's a little different. What we actually do is we're going to connect to the data source and we grab the schema of the data. So the table structure, right? The column names, that type of information. And that is stored inside of Power BI Desktop in the data model, but the data itself stays at the data source. So this is beneficial for a lot of different reasons. One of the biggest reasons and one of the limitations I called out in import is your size. So if you're working with massive data, direct query can help you get past that limit. Going back to my connection options, all it is a flip of a switch and we're gonna do direct query at that point. Then it will actually pull in that schema and not the data itself. One thing to realize is not all data sources support direct query. I've got another link in the description below with the Power BI data source list, and this actually calls out which ones support direct query and which ones do not. Typically, it's going to be your relational type data sources, so just be aware of that. One huge word of caution I'm gonna throw out here with direct query, be careful. So typically when folks call us up and they say they've got performance issues, the first question we ask is, are you using direct query? Because that's usually what the problem is. People tend to do direct query against some sort of operational database or something that's not in that star schema format or not modeled really clean. Other things that you'll hit with direct query is you're going to have some limitations from a Power Query perspective as well as DAX itself. Please do not use the time intelligence functions, as of the recording of this video, they're probably not going to be as performant, and the queries they're going to generate are not going to be the best because they're very complex in what they have to do. Going back to the performance piece on DirectQuery, typically the conversations I have is customers will say, no, we've modeled this correctly. It's amazing. The database is fast. And we go look at the queries and it's not, right? It's all got to be sub-second for a Power BI report and an interactive query load. Remember, every visual on the canvas can generate one or more queries to that data source over DirectQuery. So you gotta be mindful of that. All right, the next connection type is this live connection. What is that? And why is it different from DirectQuery? There is an actual difference. So live connect is specific to when we're connecting to analysis services or a Power BI dataset. So this could be Azure analysis services on-prem, or the Power BI dataset. And the reason for this is it is the gold standard, right? So Power BI, the heart of Power BI is that VertiPack engine, which is used across all of those properties. And so all this is, I mentioned in DirectQuery that we copy over the schema. From a live connection perspective, what we actually have is just the connection string. Everything is kept on the model itself. We don't bring anything over to Power BI desktop. So for example, if I go to Power BI datasets, and let's say that I just want my sales model, and we'll say create. And what this is gonna do is we've got that connection string to that data set. Another thing you'll mention over on the side here, I've only got my report tab and I've only got my model view. I don't have the data view because that's just not available from my live connect perspective. And by default here, you can't make changes to that model, right? That model is an external source, and from Power BI desktop's perspective, you're not going to be able to make those changes. If you do, this is where composite models come into play. So composite models is a feature where it allows you to mix and match the connection types. So we've got DirectQuery, we've got import, and now as of the December 2020 build of Power BI desktop, you can also mix and match over live connections to Power BI datasets and Azure analysis services, which is amazing. Just as a quick example here, maybe I want to import an item like a CSV file. Here, it's going to prompt you, hey, because we have a live connect, you have to change this over to a DirectQuery connection. So now I'm doing DirectQuery to the actual AS model or the Power BI dataset. And so we're going to create a local model, which has that schema now and references to the model that is the Power BI dataset. So let me go ahead and we'll bring in my CSV file, and I'm just going to import that. So now I've got an imported table combined with my live connect table, and now they can live together, right? And so if I go to my model view, now these are all together. We can see the blue is my live connect, and then my subcategory table is over here, and I can do what I need to do to mash up that data. Be sure to check out the video I did with Tessa Herr, where we go a little more in depth about what the DirectQuery over Power BI datasets can do. You can take advantage of other items with composite models as well. So when we look at aggregation or summary tables, that's imported, and then we use the direct query table. So this helps you work with that massive data. So layers are going to be your friend with massive data. We've got that imported summary table, which will handle maybe 90% of the query operations. When you want to get to that detail row, it works on the direct query table, and you can satisfy those business requests in your report itself. What do you guys think? Did this help clear up what the different connection types are and what you can do inside of Power BI? Check the description for links to other resources on these topics, and let me know in the comments below what you think. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.